Thank you. Thank you. Baptist history because it has managed to bring together multiple generations of Baptist believers. We have our all of our alums from the very beginning, we have our founder here as well, to the most recent alums from last year. We have our current Baptist Street Chamber peers, who you just heard, and then we hopefully have many future Baptist Street Chamber peers in our audience right now. So it's really a special event. I just wanted to also say that this organization has meant so much to me. Even before I came to Harvard, I knew about the existence of this organization, and this was really one of the reasons why I wanted to come to Harvard. I was really fortunate enough to have a lot of mentors and friends who was already part of this organization, and I really wanted to join, and once I joined, I learned about the amazing culture and dedication to music that I already had heard from and more. I found amazing friends here, so I really hope that the pre-cross consider auditioning next fall. So yeah, so before I pass the mic to our founder, I also want to take a little time to talk about the next piece. As you can see, the stage is being set up for something else, and that's because we are playing Elgar's Introduction and Allegro, which was written for a solo quartet and a string ensemble. So we have our four amazing alums who have agreed to come back. So we'll have Alex and Lee Tai here in the violins, and then we'll have Martin Thomas and Aiden Cobb on the cello. And the rest of the alums who have managed to come will be playing with us in the rest of the orchestra. As I emailed a lot of alums, it really meant a lot to me that a lot of them, even the ones who couldn't come, emailed me back, and it really is a testament to how great this organization is and what kind of an important part Bradley played in their college years. So it really shows that everybody's really dedicated to this organization. So yeah, so that was my little spiel, and I'll also pass on the mic to Jen Cross, who's our founder, and without her vision, we wouldn't be here. So thank you so much, Jen.
Intro. organizational, you know, cooperation. There was sort of this like weird Lord of the Fly dynamics. There was mental, physical, and emotional presence that was needed. And we were all just forced to listen, forced to adjust. And so honestly today, it's like, it's modern day therapy. That's how I look at it. Everyone playing without a conductor means that you need to be super in tune with everybody else. And it's a very special experience if you haven't had it yet. As I said, the alumni, over probably 125, maybe more, they have won major competitions. They have played in world renowned orchestras. They have taught or are still teaching at Juilliard, for example. And many, many others are doctors, lawyers, investors, people in the tech space. Like, they've all moved on and done incredible things. And I noticed, by the way, in the program that only two of all of these players are music majors. So everybody, music and something else. I saw music and physics, and I saw, I think, music and economics. And so people are pursuing all kinds of things while being exceptional musicians, so that's very inspiring. And I want to say that one key note, the original inspiration besides our goals was my mother, who is almost 80 and is sitting in the audience up there, because my mother, in 1994, started a conductorless orchestra called the Sejong Soloists. And it is a very well-known, world-renowned conductorless orchestra today. And she was my original inspiration.
Thank you. Thank you.